When you're in a cholera outbreak, every single number tells a story. But what happens when one of those numbers is actually telling you the wrong story entirely, sending life-saving efforts in completely the wrong direction? We're going to see how one really common calculation mistake can have deadly consequences and how to fix it. To understand the problem, picture this. You're monitoring a cholera outbreak. Two people have tragically died from cholera. The first person passed away at a health facility despite receiving treatment. This is a health facility death. The second person died at home, never reaching care. This is a community death. Community deaths include people who died at home, died on the way to a facility, or arrived at a health facility already dead. Same disease, same tragic outcome. But here's the crucial question. Should you count those two deaths the same way? The answer is no. Many cholera surveillance systems make the same mistake. Here's how it happens. You take all the deaths you know about, the person who died at the health facility and the person who died in the community, and you lump them together. Then you divide that total by the number of sick people who showed up at health facilities. What you get is a single number, the case fatality ratio, or CFR. Do you see the problem? You've added community deaths to the numerator, but you completely forgot to add community cases to the denominator. And this is where the massive bias problem comes in. Deaths are dramatic. They're visible. They get noticed and reported, even in communities. But what about all the other people in that same community who got sick with milder cases and just recovered at home? They're invisible in your data. They never showed up at a health facility. They never got counted. So when you include community deaths in your CFR, you're inflating the numerator with deaths from everywhere. But your denominator only counts cases from health facilities. It's mathematically biased. It's epidemiologically wrong. And it gives you a dangerously misleading picture of your outbreak. Even worse, it sends you chasing the wrong problem. Let's go back to those two deaths. They tell completely different stories. On one side, you have the patient who made it to a health facility, who got treatment, who was in the system. On the other side, you have the person who died in the community, at home, without ever getting formal medical care. In a nutshell, a death at a facility tells you primarily about quality of clinical care. Maybe treatment protocols weren't followed. Maybe supplies ran out. Maybe health workers weren't sufficiently trained, and so on. A death in the community tells you about access to care. Maybe the health facility was too far away. Maybe the family couldn't afford transport. Maybe they didn't trust the system. Maybe they didn't even know treatment was available. Different deaths. Different problems, different solutions. And if you mix them together, you just won't know which problem you're dealing with. So if mixing all the mortality data together is the problem, what's the fix? It's actually really simple, and it's powerful. Instead of one broken indicator, you monitor two separate, crystal clear indicators. Indicator number one. The real case fatality ratio, CFR. The formula is clean. You only count deaths that happened inside a health facility, and you divide that by the number of cases seen at health facilities. That's it. In a nutshell, this number primarily tells you one thing. How good is the quality of care for people who manage to get there? Target: less than 1%, ideally close to zero. Because with proper treatment, cholera deaths are almost entirely preventable. Indicator number two, number of community deaths. This is a count, not a ratio, not a percentage, just a simple tragic count of deaths happening in the community, including anyone who arrived at a facility already dead. This number tells you nothing about quality of care. It tells you about access to care. Target: zero, because any community death means someone couldn't or wouldn't reach care. Each indicator tells you something specific, and more importantly, something you can act on. Here's the crucial point. In an outbreak, using the right data to make the right decision quickly is what saves lives. Mix your mortality data and you'll misdiagnose the crisis. Get the indicators right and you'll direct interventions exactly where they're needed. When CFR is high, you know you need to assess clinical care and other potential issues. Train health workers, send more supplies, fix treatment protocols, and so on. When community deaths occur, you know you need to get out into the communities. Set up treatment centers right where people are dying. Strengthen risk communication. Address barriers that prevent people from seeking care. Having the right data is the only way you can take the right action. And the difference here is literally life and death. And we have to remember why all of this is so incredibly important. Almost all deaths from cholera are preventable. This is a disease people should not be dying from. With adequate rehydration, people survive. Getting the data right is one of the most fundamental steps to making sure that prevention becomes a reality. Getting this one simple distinction in mortality data right allows us to direct our efforts precisely where they're needed most. That turns data into action that saves lives. Two different indicators, two different problems, two different solutions. If you only take away three things from this, let it be these. First, the case fatality ratio, the CFR, when you calculate it correctly, measures primarily quality of care. You only use data from health facilities, facility deaths divided by facility cases. Second, community deaths measure access to care. They must be counted and reported separately. Never include them in your CFR calculation. Third, monitor them both separately, so you know where the real problem is and where to send help. The golden rule, never mix them. So, we've just seen how calculating correctly cholera mortality indicators leads directly to life-saving action. So it raises the question, if using the right data saves lives, what are the real-world costs in public health of getting it wrong? Don't let a calculation error cost lives. Together, we can end cholera.